And there is prejudice against them the way they look too. If you've got long hair, they'll be there.
Only short hair gets it.
Yeah.
So, Shane, would it be worth cutting your hair?
Be given in, and there's no proof that I'll get a job anyway.
So A Current Affair organised career opportunities on beautiful South Mole Island. Welcome aboard.
I'm not going to sit here and beg you to take the job. I've got all these people here that want the job, but it's a chance. You make a decision, it's your decision, and it's back in your court.
I want the job, but I don't want to cut my hair.
Mark, Bindi and Shane Paxton are not here for a holiday. All long-term unemployed, they're here to try and turn their lives around.
The future doesn't look that good.
But are they doing enough?
Why do I have to get out of bed?
12 past 12.
17-year-old brother, Mark. There's just no reason to get out of bed.
Let me sleep for a little bit longer.
You guys get out of bed pretty late.
I'll wake up about 9 o'clock, look at the clock, think, why do I have to get out of bed?
Do you think politicians and governments in general understand what you're really going through?
Nah, they wouldn't have a clue. Not at all.
Why?
If they had to come and live here, they wouldn't handle it.
They'd hang themselves.
Yeah, they would.
Mike Munner with that report, pretty stark stuff, isn't it? As I said, there was an incredible response to our story last night on the Paxton family and their complaints about the lack of job opportunities.
Most viewers believe the Paxtons are unfairly blaming the system for holding them back, saying the younger members of the family would have a much better chance of getting a job if they change the way they look and the way they dress.
So, Shane, would it be worth cutting your hair?
No. I don't want to cut it. I should be, that's not stopping me from doing the work.
It shouldn't have any effect.
No.
They were desperate for work, offered jobs of a lifetime. So what happens when they're put to the
tropical paradise on the Great Barrier Reef, smack bang in the middle of the Whitsundays, where thousands of tourists flock to take it easy.
So what do you think?
I like it. Good to be here.
But Mark, Bindi and Shane Paxton are not here for a holiday. All long-term unemployed, they're here to try and turn their lives around.
Now you've got to sell me and tell me why I've got to be choosing you instead of choosing one of these people.
Oh, I'm hardworking. I could do any of the work you wanted me to do.
Yeah.
And I'm good for talking to people. I'm not shy. Okay. I'm a big boy. I can lift lots of things. I have no problem getting along with people. I'm honest, hardworking, and I won't let you down.
I'm in a band, so I'm used to working with people.
Yeah.
And dealing with the public.
To deal with the haircuts. That's what
it's got to be a haircut. These are the grooming standards that everybody meets. I can't have exceptions.
Do you realise that you are throwing away a fantastic opportunity?
I'm not throwing it. I would take the opportunity. I'm
not throwing it away.
But I'm just not cutting my hair for it. It does not affect how I work. It does not change who I am for a job.
Obviously, you're going to have to wear the uniform to keep the job.
Most viewers thought that the Paxtons were rather using and abusing the system, not doing nearly enough to get a job and get off the dole.
Oh, where is Ray? I'm going to go in. I happen to know that Ray knows who I am, so I've brought along a disguise, my Mike Munro paper mache head. Will you please come out, Mr. Martin? It's 9:30, Mr. Martin. Why aren't you at work? Don't you think you owe ordinary Australians an explanation? Taxpayers, battlers, ordinary hard-working Australians, war veterans, many of them caught in factory machinery, they all have to go to work in the morning. Why aren't you at work in the morning, Mr. Martin? Just answer the question, Mr. Martin.
We wanted to ask why you weren't at work at 9 in the morning.
I have a program that goes on at 6:30 at night. I leave, I get home at 8 o'clock at night. The previous night before you trespassed on my property, I was at work until 5 past 11 doing a special that we're doing.
Everyone's doing it tough in Australia at the moment,
absolutely,
though.
Absolutely, we're all doing it tough.
We all have to tighten our belts.
Did you talk to people next door and talk to people in the street? What did you ask them?
No, we didn't ask them anything.
We don't do that.
Didn't speak to anybody?
I didn't go to the right journalism school.